conflicted. Here's why. On the one hand, I'm quite pleased. I'm wearing my star sweatshirt today in honor of America Chavez. But I'm very happy because A, my reporting has been proven correct once again. I've been telling you for months that this is going to happen and this is the way it's going to happen, and it's happening. And also, I know how important the representation is for so many of you that Young Avengers brings to the table. But that's a perfect reason for me to flip to why I'm concerned, because now that I see who they've cast as America Chavez, I don't know if you're going to get the representation that you were hoping for. I don't know if Kevin Feige can do the Young Avengers the way they're meant to be done. We're going to talk about it, but I never suspected he was going to Disney Channel them, because they're the most un-Disney Channel team probably ever created, and we're going to break all that down. Now, some of you might be like furiously typing, because you've been doing that a lot lately. You're like, oh, Grace, who cares about representation? It's about the actor and picking the best person for the job. Well, let me just tell you that Young Avengers is all about representation. That's like the whole reason the group, the comic book was created. And it's very pivotal. It's been at the forefront of getting LGBT representation in comics and diversity and representing, you know, a lot of people today. Very, very important in that regard. It didn't win a bunch of GLAAD awards for nothing. And also, it makes me a little sad because I think that a number of people, people who are hopefuls, want to be actors and they'd love to be in the MCU. There's so many people with these days. But, you know, there are people who fit with the Young Avengers who are like, man, if I were going to be in the MCU, I'd be in the Young Avengers team. That would be representing me. But if Kevin Feige says, you know what, we're not going to do that, that's like saying those people don't have a place in the MCU. And I think that would just be an absolute disaster for Kevin Feige if that's what he even he's going to be inadvertently saying that if that's indeed what he does here. So let's break it down. I mean, this is really an important situation. And, you know, Kevin Feige has, you know, been called out for not having diversity in the MCU. And he's avoided controversy by not having it. And so far, with the little bit of diversity that he's brought in, like Captain Marvel, he's had problems. Some people even mean about Black Panther, which boggles my mind, because, you know, Black Panther is a flawless film. I've even come around to really enjoy Captain Marvel. It's not the Captain Marvel that I would have created, but I'm starting to appreciate it for what it is. And I also just like having a popular female character in the mix, and that means a lot to me. So, you know, like, for instance, this recent art on the Disney store shows the Marvel characters, and I just love seeing Captain Marvel there in such a great position. So I'm like, whatever it takes to get this makes me happy. And that's how I feel about Captain Marvel, is how a number of people in the LGBT and diverse communities feel about the Young Avengers. So to deny them that would be really bad. All right, so everything I've been telling you, as I said, for the past few months is happening. The Young Avengers are assembling in the MCU movies and Disney Plus TV shows. And then they shall come together, either in a movie or their own Disney Plus series. Kevin Feige is still deciding. Heck, they might come together in both, but the team is assembling. I also told you that Kevin Feige wants to go with actual teenagers for the roles, with the exception of Kate Bishop, who'd be the one adult in the group as a mentor slash advisor, and hopefully be Hailee Steinfeld. She is Kate Bishop. If they can't land her for that role, it'll haunt the show and the character forever. Anyway, Bishop is often the leader of the Young Avengers, and in most recently the West Coast Avengers in the comics, so that would work. And after Ms. Marvel was cast just recently, now Xochitl Gomez joins Doctor Strange 2 in an undisclosed role. But we all know she's Miss America, aka America Chavez, as it's been known for some time that the character would debut in Doctor Strange 2. I've heard it from my sources and reported it. Other scoopers have heard it from their sources and reported it. It's like a very poorly kept secret, to the point that I'm surprised the trades were like, I don't know who she's playing. And it's like, don't you? We all know who she's playing. It's ridiculous. And part of her power set is that she punches star-shaped holes in reality to be able to jump from one to the other. A perfect character for Doctor Strange 2 in the Multiverse of Madness. It's getting a little crowded, but we'll see how it works out. But again, suddenly, seeing the actress, seeing Xochitl Gomez, and them saying, this is Miss America, I had a pang of a feeling that I was like, you know, maybe Kevin Feige has made a mistake deciding to bring the Young Avengers into the MCU. Because again, it seems he's giving them the Disney Channel treatment. And there is not a team that I can think of that is less fitting with the Disney Channel treatment than the Young Avengers. I mean, this is America Chavez in the MCU, and this is the original character that everybody, I mean, she has a fan base, and this is who they like. So if this is who they like, I don't understand. I'm having trouble wrapping my head around how you can give them this. And, with, you know, I don't want another Kelly Marie Tran situation. I don't want Xochitl Gomez to have to deal with that. And, you know, that's that would be on Disney for putting her in that position. But she's just not what anybody expected. It's like worse than, you know, expecting Storm and getting like Halle Berry and Alexandra Shipp, who, you know, no fault of their own, but they're just not Storm. And Xochitl Gomez, I think, unfortunately, is not America Chavez. I mean, she's gone from being a dark Latina superpowered sex pot to, well, to put it politely, Hollywood's idea of a Latina and why they keep getting called out for it. I mean, colorism, once again. I can't believe that Hollywood keeps making mistakes about colorism. It is like one of the simplest, most obvious things that they've done, and they can't even fix that. I mean, it's really frustrating. Also, the character, again, stars are a motif for her, and she's often surrounded by them. And she, you know, she's fun. She wears like a lot of fun athletic activewear. She's got like, she incorporates the American flag into her outfit. I think sometimes ironically, you know, she has cool, like she's been shown with like, these cool like American flag sunglasses and stuff. But all of a sudden I'm like, oh wait, I can see why someone would think this would make a great Disney Channel character. But it would be absolutely appalling to the people who love the character because that's not what they want. So I think Kevin Feige could be making a really big mistake. So as you can see in the comics, America Chavez, aka Miss America, is a Latina LGBT superhero who comes from another planet. She's an alien with two moms, which could be, I think, Disney Channel-esque, that element of her story. She's bisexual, to be exact, and a very active bisexual character. I'm not quite sure how they're going to do that with someone who looks as young as Xochitl Gomez. We're going to discuss that. And she was brought into the Young Avengers team for Volume 2. Now, Young Avengers overall as a team was co-created by openly gay writer Alan Heinberg, who, by the way, scripted 2017's Wonder Woman and came up with the brilliant idea of giving her the Disney princess treatment. And he wasn't invited back to script Wonder Woman 1984. I'm not saying Wonder Woman 1984 won't be good, but I'll never, ever get over the fact that Alan Heinberg wasn't invited back for the second movie. I will never get over it. It's so unfair, in my opinion. But anyway, he created the team, and he did Volume 1. And then Volume 2 was written by Kieran Gillen, another fantastic comic book writer, who himself is bisexual. And the title has been a beacon of representation, particularly for the LGBT community. Won, as I said, a number of GLAAD awards. And not just with America Chavez, that has iconic couple front and center, Wiccan and Hulkling, and where an innocent, passionate kiss between the two of them almost got the comic banned in Brazil just last year, even though the story came out years before that. Some political mayor was like, you know, seized on it to try and make some noise, and he ended up making the wrong kind of noise because he was easily defeated. And also, Wiccan and Hulkling were most recently at the center of Marvel's Empire event, both in positions of power, but also as the story's romantic subplot, main romantic subplot. I mean, the event itself wasn't so great, but it was a big deal and fantastic to see a gay couple as the focus of a mainstream comic book event, both in terms of like the personal story, but also the A storyline in terms of positioning for power and fights and, you know, political intrigue and all that. It was just really fantastic, really a big deal. And you know why people are excited about Wanda's twins showing up in WandaVision? Not because they like speed. Nobody even really likes speed at all. They're excited because that means that this relationship is coming. And expect Hulkling to show up either in the Secret Invasion series on Disney Plus, the Nick Fury show, or in Captain Marvel 2. But speaking of speed, he and Prodigy, Speed again is Wiccan's twin brother, but Speed and Prodigy are also LGBT characters in Young Avengers, and in fact, they are a couple as well, who are also featured in Empire with some really good scenes. The LGBT scenes in Empire were in fact the best of what I read of the comic. The point I'm trying to make here is that you cannot have the Young Avengers without LGBT representation. You can't separate the two. In addition to the LGBT representation, Young Avengers has just been an edgy title overall. Think more Riverdale than Babysitter's Club. Yet who got hired to be a Young Avenger? A Babysitter's Club cast member. And with a cast that looks so young, I worry that this might be a way to get around the LGBT representation. They might say, oh, well, it's too early for these characters to discuss their sexual identities, which of course we know isn't true because many people know their sexual identity way before they would even think about who they were interested in, you know, sexually. I mean, everybody of any sexuality, you know, can have a crush or find someone attractive at a young age. And so obviously that the LGBT conversation starts quite early for many, many, many people, if not most people. So I think that's a problem. I worry about that. But then why create a bigger obstacle for the success of the Young Avengers by making them preteens discussing sexuality instead of full-on teenagers? The MCU, like Disney itself, is very popular, not just, you know, with the coasts and, more liberal groups, but it's also very popular with conservatives. It's four-quadrant appeal. Everyone loves Disney. Everyone loves Marvel. So you can't, you know, you really want to include, make those, have those groups like the Young Avengers as well. So it's going to be harder to get them to like the Young Avengers if they feel these characters are too young to be having these conversations. So why do it to them? Why put them in a difficult position? Now, for instance, also, Disney wouldn't put Love, Victor on Disney Plus. And I have to say, they had a very racy clip that they first debuted for the show. And everyone was like, yeah, it shouldn't be on Disney Plus. But having now watched the show, which is so good, it got renewed for season two over on Hulu where it ended up, it totally could be on Disney Plus. It's a very sweet, innocent, lovely show. I think the characters on that show seem older than Xochitl Gomez. I'm not sure how old Xochitl Gomez actually is. I couldn't find it when I was looking before I filmed this video. Like, for instance, the Ms. Marvel actress looks like she's like 12, but she's actually 18. But, you know, I'd say Love, Victor has more of a Riverdale-style cast than Babysitter's Club. And Babysitter's Club, by the way, is a great show. It's just for, I mean, Netflix even puts it in the kids category. It's not even in the regular show category because that's how much for kids it is. So it just gives you an idea of the type of actors you're dealing with. So Young Avengers is like Love, Victor, but that would be watered down Young Avengers. So like Love, Victor is like as watered down as you could get for the Young Avengers and still be Young Avengers. So if Disney isn't cool with Love, Victor, how on earth are they going to be cool with the Young Avengers? And now I'm starting to get concerned because this casting makes me feel like they indeed are not. Gomez is a fun actress. She did a very nice job on Babysitter's Club, and she did play a proactive, progressive character who was like into protesting and stuff like that. That's like what her character was. She was a free spirit, you know, like Wiccans and protesting, stuff like that. You know the Hollywood, you know that kind of character in Hollywood. But she's extremely Disney Channel. She's so Disney Channel. So anyone, again, looking for this America Chavez is going to be disappointed if this is the America Chavez that they get. And it's the one they are getting. Our only hope is Sam Raimi, who, of course, is directing this. He's not very Marvel himself. He's not very Disney himself. So it's funny to see him in this world. Although he did do Oz the Great and Powerful, which was surprisingly watered down for Sam Raimi and was not one of his most successful works, come to think of it. So hopefully he can be somewhere in the middle. But maybe he can make he can cast his own magic to make this work. Doctor Strange 2 begins shooting ASAP as soon as Benedict Cumberbatch finishes his Spider-Man 3 scenes, which is that film itself is about to begin filming this very month. And both films are shooting in Atlanta back to back, if not simultaneously. They just have to wait for Benedict Cumberbatch to become available. And, you know, we've been talking about the fact that it's a one long multiverse story starting in WandaVision, then going to Spider-Man 3, then going to Doctor Strange 2. So there's overlap in the story itself. It's one big story. So not only Benedict Cumberbatch is going to be working on both films, but I would expect other characters to pop back and forth between them as well. Which is going to be awesome. It's going to be great. But again, why would you put a problem on this where everyone's like, I love it, but look what you did to the Young Avengers. Like, why would you do that to yourself? It just, I mean, like, why go down this path if you're not willing to actually go down it? So what do you think of this casting? And also, as the Young Avengers are made mainstream for Disney, where do you draw the line? What stuff has to be brought over for you to feel they're still the Young Avengers? And what, you know, I if they Disney Channel them, Kevin Feige's going to find out what it's like to be DC. He's like, oh, this is what it's like to make DC movies. A lot of yelling and screaming from the fans and to make Star Wars films. I think he'd be nuts to Disney Channel them. And I'm very nervous about that. I hope someone maybe pulls him aside and says, don't Disney Channel him, Feige. They're going to write it on your tombstone. It's going to be such a bad thing for you. All right, share your thoughts down below. Subscribe today. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.